Hi everyone, today I'm going to talk about chain of responsibility. Chain of responsibility is a design pattern that belongs to behavioral pattern family. As you know, design patterns are best practice that the programmer can use to solve common problems when designing an application or a system. We have some process in software development. In chain of responsibility, we think of this process as a chain. At each link of the chain, the handler decides to process the request or send it to the next node of the chain. For example, in real life, we consider that a bank has an approval mechanism for a loan. The approver of each amount will have separate roles. The bank employee in each role approves this amount if the amount is within his authority. If it's not, employee sends to manager. This process continues as a chain. On the use case, the client sends the process. After that, the handler handles the request. These classes, which inherited from this handler and are loosely coupled to each other, decide whether the incoming request will be processed or forwarded to the other connected class. The handler class must be generic and makes this decision during runtime. Let's develop this scenario with the chain of responsibility design pattern with Java. Right now, I have an empty Maven project with only one main class. We will run our test in the main class, so I create it. First of all, I create a class to manage the process of credit according to roles. Let's class name be Approval Authority. It will be an abstract class because this class will have common properties of the roles. And the reason I made it abstract, this class will not make sense on its own. It just be template. I will only use inherited classes. The employee in each role must have a supervisor to give approval. So I create an attribute of approval authority type and define an abstract function that will bring the maximum limit of each employee can approve. After that, another function will bring us the role of the employee. These methods will be abstract. I will override it in the subclass soon. And let's define setSuccessor method to determine approval for each employee. And finally, of course, let's write the process that will run when a bank employee approves the credit. I define a method called handleRequest. This will take the credit amount as a parameter and we will check in the code whether this amount is suitable for this user. If the credit amount of the employee can approve is greater than the given amount, we write message in console that credit has been approved and current role. As we will direct the request to supervisor of employee, and the chain of responsibility is here. Now, let's create the classes of bank employee roles that will be inherited from approval authority class. I will create a bank teller as a first level. Extend from approval authority class, override the methods. This user's max approval limit is $1,000 and role is bank teller. The second level is a bank manager. Extend from approval authority class again and override the methods. This user's max approval limit is $10,000 and role is bank manager. Create a bank director as the third level. This user's max approval limit is $100,000 and role is bank director. And finally, let's define a CEO, like the owner of the bank, and this user's max approval limit be unlimited. After all, this is my world right now. I made it as I wanted, but it's not really like that. And his role is the CEO. Yes, we are ready now. I'm gonna test it. First of all, I will define all user roles in the main class. Bank teller, manager, director, and finally CEO. Now let's assign a successor to these roles. Bank teller set successor is manager. For manager is director. For director is CEO. No one above the CEO. Now let's try. For example, amount is $100 and I will start the approval process from bank teller and run. We saw that the credit approved and my role bank teller message. Okay, it's right. We continue. If we make 10,000, we see the director approve, because the director could approve up to 1,000. If we enter a much larger value, we will see the CEO approve. Also, enter a value that the manager will approve. I entered $8,000 because his limit was $10,000 and we see that the manager approves. So, in this structure, when we call the handle request method from a role, it first checks whether its own role is suitable for this amount, and if not, it continues from the next chain. This kind of scenario is possible in main project, and chain of responsibility is very good solution. Thank you very much for watching. I would be very happy if you like my video and subscribe my channel. Happy coding!